You are most welcome in Santosh Kumar's official YouTube channel. I am Santosh Kumar. Today we will learn about tense. When we study tense, a question comes in our mind: what is tense? What is tense? The answer of the question is like this. The word tense comes from the Latin word tempus. It means time. Here you see the word tense. We can break it T for time and SE for sense. Here, time and sense are two words that make tense. Then, what will be the definition? The definition of tense will be: tense tells us the sense of time in a sentence. Now, there is a relation between two terms, time and tense. But there are also differences between these two. Number one, time is not a grammatical term, whereas tense is a grammatical term. Number two, time is universal concept. Here, universal concept means worldwide idea. While tense is not worldwide idea, universal concept. Number three, time is free from language, whereas tense is not free from language. Number four, time denotes days, months, years, etc., but tense does not. In grammar, tense is a category that expresses the time reference. The basic tenses found in English language include present tense. What is present tense? An action which is done in present is in present tense. Number two, past tense. What is past tense? An action which was done in the past is in past tense. Number three, future tense. What is future tense? An action which will be done in future is in future tense. There are sub tenses also. Identify these tenses. See the table here. I have written, it is a trick to know that which sentence is in which tense. Look at here. Verb 1. Letter ending with S and or E is in simple present. Verb 2, that means past tense. Verb ending with D is in past tense. Remember it. When model ending with the letter L, it is in future tense. What is model? Model is a part of helping verb. Now, morphemes, ing. What are morphemes? When we add D, S, ES, ing in first form of verb, these are called morphemes. Here ing is a morpheme. When there is ing in a verb, it denotes continuous tense. Now, was, where, am, has, have, had, these are models also. And was where denotes past tense, am denotes present tense, h is the first letter of have or has or had. H plus v3, that means have plus v3, has plus v3 or have plus v3, had plus v3, it denotes perfect. See the example. She plays cricket. Here you see S denotes present tense. Which tense? Present tense. And it is in simple present. Very easy trick to know the sentence. Which sentence is in which tense? It is very easy to know. Here you see S. It denotes present tense. And this sentence is in simple present. Likewise, she played cricket. Here you see the verb ending with D. D in denotes past tense. It is in past tense. That means it is in simple past. The sentence she played cricket is in simple past tense. Understand? It is very easy to understand. Now, let us see. She will play cricket. She will play cricket. Here you see L. The modal ending with L. It is L denotes future. Future tense. That means it is in simple future tense. Okay. Now, she is playing cricket. She is playing cricket. Here you see S. S denotes present and ing denotes continuous. Thus, this sentence is, she is playing cricket, is in present continuous. Okay? Now, look at here. She was playing cricket. In the chart, in the table, you see was or were are in past tense. Here you see in the sentence there is was, and was is in past tense. Was denotes past tense, and ing morpheme denotes continuous. Ing denotes continuous. Thus, this sentence, she was playing cricket, is in past continuous. Okay? Now, she has played cricket. She has played cricket. You see H. H is perfect. When H is added with verb 3. Here, played is in V3. And here H denotes perfect. Perfect tense. And S denotes present. S denotes present. Thus, she has played cricket is in present perfect tense. Okay? Do you like it, students? Now, she had played cricket. She had played cricket. identify this sentence. In which tense is this sentence? Now, H is for perfect and D for past tense. In this way, she had played cricket is in past perfect tense. Now, she will be playing cricket. Here you see L. L denotes future tense and ing denotes continuous. This sentence, she will be playing cricket, is in future continuous tense. Very easy to know. Now, she will have played cricket. She will have played cricket. Here L denotes future tense. H denotes perfect. That means this sentence, she will have played cricket, is in future perfect tense.